What's the difference between Cat5, Cat6, and Cat6A? It's here somewhere.
The Cat6A?
Yeah.
That's those big rolls.
What I want to talk a little bit about is to you gamers, you homeowners, you do-it-yourselfers, I'm assuming that you bumped into this video and you need to figure this out. What is the big difference with these categories and what do I do? What's the best bang for my buck? You know, some of these cables are pretty expensive. You do not want to basically waste money. You don't want to spend extra cash for something that's not going to benefit you. So let's go ahead and check these cables out. And first I want to talk about Cat5E. Well, the three standards. There's Cat5E, there's Cat6, and there's Cat6A. Those are the three standards that are in place, okay? Now, for more information on the standards, if you want to check that out and figure out what is going on, where do these standards come from? Who sets this in, who decides, let's go ahead and set this in stone, let's make it like the Ten Commandments, right? Let's lay it down and this is how it is. Okay, so you're going to want to go to the American National Standards Institute, okay? Now, they pretty much, they lay it in stone. Go to their website. I'll put a link in the bottom there in the comment section or in the description where you can go ahead and click on that if you want to dive into who these people are. And they also work with, now this is probably for this type of industry, the cable, copper, the data cabling, structured wire, commercial buildings, homes, all that good stuff. TIA, the Telecommunications Industry Association, okay? You'll find TIA 568B. We'll get into that a little bit later, but so if you want to poke around there, I'll put a link in the bottom there where you can go ahead and click on it, kind of browse around over there. But that's who sets these standards in stone as far as Cat5E, Cat6, and Cat6A. So that's what's set in stone. Now, let's go ahead and start with the Cat5E. Okay, now if you're looking into purchasing some cable, and you'll hear a lot of people just say, oh, just get some Cat5, just Cat5, okay. Now you go to the store and you're looking at patch cables, maybe you're looking at bulk cable to redo your home, that sort of thing. Cat5 is pretty much outdated. I think the last time any of it was made was probably back in 2001. Now there's Cat5E, and basically what that standard calls out for is doing gigabit, 1 gigabit up to 328 feet. Now that's pretty far. You can, hey, that's longer than a football field. So that's pretty cool. You can get a gig, you know, install that and, you know, redo your wiring. And yeah, you'll probably be just fine if you got to do gaming, you got to do maybe small business, that sort of thing. That'll probably suit your needs. You know, I got a niche right here. But so the other thing we're going to do is we're going to compare these cables. So let's go ahead and check out the Cat5E cable right now, and then we'll go ahead and compare one. We'll put them all together so you can all take a look at them. This is your Category 5E cable, as you can tell, and it's a solid conductor. You always want to use your solid conductor for when you're doing long runs from the patch panel to the wall outlet. So stranded, that's for making patch cords. Stay away from that. It's a 24 gauge. That's the standard for Cat5E, a 24 gauge copper conductor. And you see the 350 megahertz, the standard's 100, we'll get to that. ETL verified. And it's verified to the ANSI. The construction of the cable, when you strip the jacket off, you have four pairs. You have your blue, you have your brown, you have your green, you have your orange. It's got a certain amount of twist to the cable, to each pair. So that way, when you test it, it'll certify to the Cat5E standard. Pretty straightforward. Okay, so the 350 megahertz, you notice that on that Cat5E cable, the standard is 100 megahertz. Now, a lot of these manufacturers, they will put 350 on the jacket nowadays, and some of these manufacturers, they put that on there so that way they would get you to pay more money for that product, okay? The standard is 100 megahertz. The 350, there's no, TIA has not specified a standard for what a lot of people, for a few years, many years ago, people would call that Big E. The 350 megahertz, I would need the Big E. But there's no standard for it, so you would be paying more money for something that wasn't even promised as far as what the performance of that cable would be. Now, one of the things, if you have time, you want to do this, I've done this, there's spec sheets on these cables from a lot of these reputable manufacturers. When you print them out, you compare one to the other, one to the other, you will see that their Big E 350 megahertz cable, the report will be different from one to the other. There's no standard that it needs to be. And some of these lower end manufacturers, you know, you think you're saving a couple bucks, maybe you get the, you step up, you get the Big E. It's nothing more than print on the jacket. So if you buy a reputable brand, you're getting a little more bang for your buck, possibly, but there's no standard, so who knows what you're paying for. Okay, so just a heads up there. That's kind of gone away over the past few years. There's not a discussion of the Big E and 5E, but maybe there's confusion with the Cat6, possibly. So let's go ahead and let's check out the Cat6 cable. Okay, so this is your Cat6 cable. As you can tell, it's at the 250 megahertz standard. It is also a 23 gauge, so it has a little bit of a thicker copper conductor. Now let's go ahead and strip the jacket off so you can see what the pairs look like underneath. And don't forget, with Cat6, you also have to use the Cat6 jacks, patch panels, and other components in order for it to be Cat6 compliant through your entire run. Now the pairs, as you can tell, there's a little bit of a tighter twist also compared to the Cat5, and you have the same colors, the green, the orange, the brown, and the blue. Okay, so we're going to talk about the Cat6 standard, okay? Now Cat6, you can do, maybe you're thinking Cat5E, been around since 01, 02, somewhere around there, I don't remember. Oh, it's been around for a long time. I want to go ahead and step it up just a few years. I think Cat6 came out around 2004. Maybe future-proof it, because Cat6, you can do 10 gig. Instead of 1 gig, you can do 10 gig up to 55 meters. So that's pretty far, especially for a home and a small business. 10 gig, I mean, on a cable, that'll probably give you enough oomph for probably anything you need. Now, our installation contractor customers, what they've told us when they go to their testers, they certify to check out on the big, you know, Fluke testers. A lot of guys told us that 328, 330 feet, 340, they can get up to 3 gig on that. So that's pushing it pretty far. That's still pretty good bang for your buck if you got some long runs. So now the standard for the megahertz, which drives me crazy, for Cat6 is 250. That is the standard. So Cat5E, 100. Cat6, 250. Okay. Cat5E, the 350, meh. Who knows what you're getting there? A little better than Cat5E, but remember the megahertz, some of these manufacturers, who knows what you're paying for. So, okay, so today we're going to take a look at the Cat6A. Let's take a look at the Cat6E cable. Okay, now there's a Cat6E, and this is kind of what's going on with the Cat5 biggie, like we talked about out in the market, trying to get you to pay a little extra money. You'll notice the 550 megahertz on the cable. Now, just like the Cat5 biggie, you will have some additional benefits, but there's no standard to it, so who knows what that is. But there is a noticeable difference from the Cat6 to the Cat6E. Typically, these cables will have a larger separator in between the pairs. As far as I can tell, it looks as if the twist in the pairs is about the same, but the separator inside the cable keeps all the pairs separated. And you do have some better test results as far as, you know, the crosstalk, that sort of thing. And the other thing I want to mention quickly is, you have to use Cat6 jacks and panels, as I mentioned with the Cat6 cable, for a complete end-to-end solution, but there's no Cat6E jacks or patch panels. Now there's the comparison to the Category 6 cable. These are two different manufacturers. And this Cat6E, the diameter is a little bit bigger. Okay, so here's our Cat6A cable. And it's also a 4-pair. It's a 23 gauge. Verified to the... And there it is, the 500 megahertz. That's the standard that we've mentioned. Now let's go ahead and strip the jacket off so you can see what's going on. As you can tell, there is one heck of a twist per pair there. You have the same colors, the orange, the blue, you got the green and the brown, and of course you have that separator, but it also has a twist inside the jacket, as you can noticeably tell. Now the other thing I do want to mention is this cable with that twist, it will add, you know, if you got a lot of cable and jacks to do, it will add a lot of labor as far as untwisting the pairs, punching things down. If you need help or tips on how to punch down this type of cable and jacks and panels, check out the YouTube channel. And the other thing I do want to mention is inside, let me see if I can get a shot for you here in the second here. Inside the inner jacket, it has, see those grooves? It also helps to separate everything in there a little bit and help you get that better test result that makes sure you're at that Cat6 standard. That Cat6A standard, excuse me. And there it is compared to the Cat6. As you can tell, the diameter difference is quite noticeable. Okay, so now the Cat6A cable. Now the standard for that is 500 megahertz, and you can push 10 gig the entire 328 feet. So if you need 10 gig for that long of a run, you must have a really big house. I'm just gonna call you Bill Gates, okay? You probably have a home as big as Bill Gates. You don't want to deal with that. 10 gig Cat6A, just install it. I got all kinds of money to go ahead and play with, throw around, okay, just install the best, latest and the greatest. Go for it. Hey, it's your money, do what you want. But me personally, if I wanted to redo my home network, or if you have a small business, I think best bang for your buck is going to be the Cat6 cable. 10 gig, good runs. And not only that, I'm thinking about our customers, our sales here at discountlowvoltage.com. I think about typically the Cat5E cable, the sales are, Cat5E still moves pretty good. You know, people still use it. It's a great cable for the price gig. Pretty much takes care of a lot of needs out there for everybody. Cat6 cable has, it's 2019, probably, I don't know, maybe since 2012, 2013, it feels like. And the numbers will support this, but it's getting, definitely people are paying the extra money for it. It's a little bit more now compared to what it used to be. And I think it's great value for the money. The Cat6A, now that's, over the past few years, it's there. It moves a little bit, but not like Cat6E. Used to be all Cat5E. Cat6 is moving great. Cat6 is still a little sluggish there. And I think the reason for that is, I think fiber optic cable, I mean, you know, you get one small fiber, you get a 6 strand fiber optic cable, and if you're thinking about fiber to the home or fiber for your office, check out the YouTube channel. We do have tons of fiber optic videos, how-tos, that sort of thing, but fiber, I want to say like, maybe like a 6 strand OM3 50 micron fiber, 6 strand, probably the diameter of that cable. If I remember the spec sheet right, it's 0.24 inches. That's pretty small, a quarter inch. That's about the size of your Cat5, Cat6E, Cat6 cable. Excuse me, I got caught with the E there. Cat5, Cat6 cable, it's about the same diameter. But with that one cable, you know, you get gig or you only get 10 gig up to a certain distance. The OM3, you can get 10 gig up to 900 feet. So it feels as if these commercial buildings nowadays, if there's big bandwidth needs, they're going with fiber. But you never know. Things change. Market changes. The last thing I guess I want to talk about is maybe Cat7. Forget about it. Don't even think about it. There's the ISO has a, I guess, kind of a rough draft standard. It's been out there for a little while. Some manufacturers are offering a Cat7. Hey, it's not a standard. Any manufacturer can print Cat7 on a cable. Since it's not a standard, who knows what you're getting for. I wouldn't even waste money on that. I've seen it a couple times, and you know, we've been in business since 99. I mean, nobody really calls. It's typically the guy that wants the latest and the greatest. That's you. You got the dough to spend. Big bucks. Go with the Cat6A. I would like the Cat6, but it's your money, so do what you want. Forget about Cat7. Comments below. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you're new. You've never seen any of our videos on YouTube. And I hope you guys enjoy the other videos you guys see online. We work really hard here, and we hope you guys enjoy them. Thank you. I appreciate your time. Thank you.